Good morning, students. Today we will continue with the chapter 1 of civics, the Union Parliament. Today's topic is the speaker. Today we will discuss the following points. So the objective of today's topics are as follows: his or her election, powers and functions of speaker, proceedings of the house, administrative powers, disciplinary powers, parliamentary committees, miscellaneous powers and functions. Before start the today's topic, let's discuss some keywords. Number 1, constituted, it means set up. Number 2, resolution, it means decision. Number 3, assent, means approve. Number 4, admissibility, means eligibility. Number 5, adjourn, it means suspend. Number 6, petition, it means appeal. Number 7, decorum, it means politeness. Number 8, expunged, it means erase. Open your books. Topic: the speaker. After the general elections are over, the Lok Sabha is duly constituted, means set up, with a notification, means information, by the election commission. The first task for the Lok Sabha to do is to elect its chairman and vice chairman, popularly known as the speaker and deputy speaker, respectively. The deputy speaker acts as the speaker when the latter is not present. The Speaker of the Lok Sabha is the presiding officer of the Lok Sabha. After the general elections, the first task is to elect its chairman, means speaker, and vice chairman, means deputy speaker. Deputy speaker works in the absence of speaker. His or her election. The Speaker of the Lok Sabha is elected soon after the newly elected Lok Sabha meets for the first time. Till a new speaker is elected, the speaker of the preceding means before or lead up to, Lok Sabha presides over its session. The Indian constitution provides that when the house is dissolved, the speaker shall not vacate his office. He remains in office till the new speaker is elected by the new Lok Sabha in its first meeting. The speaker as well as the deputy speaker are elected by the Lok Sabha from among its members. Normally, the speaker is elected for 5 years. He can seek re-election for any number of times if he is elected as a member of the Lok Sabha. The speaker is elected generally in the first meeting of the Lok Sabha following general elections. Newly elected members of the parliament from the Lok Sabha elect speaker among themselves. Om Birla of the BJP is the current speaker of who presides over the 17th Lok Sabha. Previous speaker presides over the meeting till the new speaker elected. The Indian constitution provides that if the house dissolved, the speaker will not leave his seat till the new speaker elected. He can re-elect it number of times. His removal. The speaker can resign his post on health ground or on other grounds by submitting a letter of resignation to the deputy speaker. He can also be removed by the Lok Sabha if a majority of the members pass resolution, means decision, to this effect. But before moving such a resolution, the constitution provides for a 14 days prior notice. During this period, the deputy speaker shall preside over the meetings of the house. Speaker can be removed by the Lok Sabha by a resolution passed by an effective majority of the house, but he has to give 14 days prior notice. During this period, deputy speaker will take the charge. Speaker can also resign his post on health issues by giving a resignation letter to deputy speaker. Powers and functions of the speaker. Various powers and functions of the speaker can be categorized as under: proceedings of the house. Proceeding means activities. He or she presides. Presides means conduct over the meetings of the house. He allots time for discussion. All speeches and remarks are addressed. Address means label to the speaker. The speaker has the final say regarding all rules and procedure of the house. All bills passed by the House are signed by the Speaker before they are sent to the Upper House or to the President for assent. Assent means approve. Now let's discuss the powers and functions of the Speaker. The Speaker conducts the meetings in House, give time for discussion. He or she is the final authority to say about the rules and conduct of the House. The passed bills sent to the Speaker for signature before sent to the Upper House. The Speaker decides the admissibility. Admissibility means eligibility of all resolutions, bills, questions and motions. Motions means movement. He can adjourn. Adjourn means suspend the meetings of the Lok Sabha. He admits important motions, that is no confidence motion or adjournment motion or other motions. He calls for votes on all bills, resolutions and motions. He announces the results. The Speaker himself, herself votes only in case of tie. The Speaker decides whether a particular bill is a money bill or not. Or he can adjourn, means suspend the House if it lacks quorum. The Speaker decides the correctness of the questions, bills, resolution. He has the full right to suspend the meetings of the Lok Sabha. Speaker can pass important motions, like no confidence motion, means a vote in which an individual or group is not able to hold the position of responsibility. Adjournment motion means it is the procedure for suspension of the business of the House for the purpose of discussing urgent matter. He can conduct voting on any motion or bill, etc. And in case of tie, he himself casts his vote. The Speaker himself decides about the bill, whether the bill is money bill or ordinary bill. He can suspend the meetings of the House if the members are less in the House. Quorum means presence of members, less members in the House. Administrative powers. The Speaker receives all the documents, letters and petitions in the House. Petition means appeal. He communicates the decisions of the House to concerned person or authorities. He controls and regulates the admissions of visitors and press correspondence. Correspondence means related or the media to the galleries of the House. All the documents, letters, appeals come first on the Speaker's desk in the House. The Speaker discusses all the matter with the higher authorities, then take the decision. And Speaker has the full control on the media, press and visitors to hear the meetings of the House in the gallery of the House. Disciplinary powers. The Speaker maintains order and decorum. Decorum means politeness in the House. He can suspend a member in case of misconduct, in case of disorder or unruly behavior by a group of members. He can adjourn the House. It is the foremost duty of the Speaker to maintain discipline in the House. He has the power to suspend any member who misbehave in the House. If words used by a member are obscene means rude, or indecent means dirty or unparliamentary, the Speaker may order that such words to be expunged. Expunged means erased from the proceedings of the House. If the wrong or rude words used by any member in the House, then the Speaker has the power to erase such words from the activities of the House. He has a final say regarding a case or matter relating to a breach. Breach means break of privilege. Privilege means advantage or contempt. Contempt means disrespect of the House. He has the final authority to give decision regarding the disrespect of the House. The decision of the Speaker is the final with regard to the question whether a member stands qualified under anti-defection law. He is the final authority to say about the member stand disqualified under anti-defection law. Anti-defection law means that a law which prevents legislators from shifting commitment to the parties they represent or disobeying their party's decision in critical times. Parliamentary committees. He appoints various parliamentary committees and guides them in their work. He appoints chairmen of all the committees of the House. He guides and issues directions to the chairmen of different parliamentary committees in all matters relating to their work and procedure. He is the ex officio chairman of some of the committees of the House, that is Rules Committee, Business Advisory Committee. The Speaker appoints various parliamentary committees like Financial Standing Committee, Department Related Standing Committee, other standing committees. He appoints the chairman of all the committees. The Speaker guides the chairman of all the committees about the procedure of the work. And the Speaker himself is the official chairman. Ex-officio chairman means official chairman of some committees like Rules Committee, Business Advisory Committee. Miscellaneous powers and functions. Miscellaneous means different. He presides over the joint sittings of the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. The Speaker conducts joint meetings of upper and lower house. He nominates members for parliamentary delegation to various countries in consultation with the chairman of the upper house. He can nominate the member of the parliamentary delegation with the consultation of chairman of Rajya Sabha. Parliamentary delegation means an official visit abroad by a member for research, negotiations, investigations. The Speaker conducts the conference. Conference means seminar of presiding officers of legislative bodies of India. The Speaker represents the House, and because the House represents the nation, in a particular way, the nation becomes the symbol of the nation's freedom and liberty. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru rightly said that the Speaker represents the nation. Because the lower house, Lok Sabha, represents the people, so Speaker becomes the symbol of the country's freedom and authority. Thank you.